boom, boom. Me and my drone.
your hands. Here we go.
Faithful, come joyful, come praising. Jesus is born in Bethlehem. His love knows no limits. Jesus is born in Bethlehem. Oh, come join the heavens. Sing worship, sing praises. Jesus is born in Bethlehem.
Anybody adore him today? Anybody adore Jesus? Love Jesus with all your heart, your mind, and your strength. I tell you, when you love Jesus, it causes you to love others around you. And I tell you what, this is the time of season that we love. What time is it, church? It's Christmas time! Somebody lift up the biggest hallelujah you can!
To us is a child in a manger, given to us, he's our King and our Savior. Yes, he is the hope of the world, he's the peace of the nations. Oh, come and adore, sing with all of the angels.
It's Christmas time.
It's Christmas time.
Promise of life spoken through all the ages.
Star in the sky, fullness of its fulfillment.
Unveiling the light, he's the truth of salvation.
Jesus is
joy to the earth, now sings all of creation.
Somebody shout what time it is.
It's Christmas time.
For all the people, peace on earth, goodwill to men.
Glory, glory, glory in the highest.
Peace on earth, goodwill to men.
Hear the story for all the people.
Peace on earth, goodwill to men.
Celebrate Christmas because we have a reason to celebrate the Savior of the world. For God so loved each and every one of us that he gave his only son, and whosoever would believe in him would not perish. We have life because Christ came. I invite you to lift your hands to heaven. Let's describe our love for him. Lord, you're so wonderful. We adore you. We're so thankful. We celebrate you as we celebrate this season. You're worthy.
Behold, the King is come, divinity incarnate, creator of the world, breathing our air. And behold, what light has come, and dark cannot contain it. The Savior of the world is finally here. Oh, come, let us adore him. Come, let us adore him. For he alone is worthy.
He gave his only son to die in our place.
all the glory. We give you all the glory. We give you all the glory, Christ the Lord.
Say it again.
We give you all the glory.
Ever. Well, I tell you what, we are just so thankful to be able to celebrate our Savior with you today. Why don't you turn to somebody near you, welcome them to church today, tell them you're glad to see them, wish them a Merry Christmas. You'll say that a couple times today, and after you do that, you can feel free to have your seats. God bless you.
Oh, come on, are you excited to be at Christmas at Faith today? Make some noise. Today is going to be absolutely amazing. Merry Christmas, everybody.
That's right. It's a lot of Christmas spirit in the room today. It feels good.
It feels so good. And by the way, Merry Christmas, Pastor Jesse.
Hey, Merry Christmas to you, Pastor David. You look good. You got a little bit of snow in your hair.
Yeah, I got a little bit of snow. I breathed in a little bit of snow, too. Hopefully, I'll be okay later.
It's been a magical morning. We love it. Hey, we are so excited to have you all here. And I'm seeing a lot of familiar faces, but I'm seeing a lot of faces I don't know yet. So I'm wondering, if it's your first time here at Faith Assembly or your first time in a long time, will you give me a wave? Because our church wants to welcome you.
Yeah.
Yes.
Welcome, everybody.
Yes.
Yeah, shoot your hand
all
up in
the back.
Air.
We love it.
Hey, welcome.
Hey, we are honored to have you here with us this morning. We love that you are here. If you would for us, would you take out your phone and text the word guest to the number on the screen, which is 407-275-8790. We want to connect with you. We want to tell you about some of the great things coming up, and we want to get you invited into our church. But also, we actually have a special welcome lounge designed just for you. And it's out these back doors, across the foyer, past that huge Christmas tree. There's actually a whole bunch of people in there that want to get to know you, hear your story, and tell you some great things coming up at Faith Assembly.
Yeah, so good. And also, if you're joining us online somewhere, welcome. Come on, can we make some noise? We got hundreds of people watching online.
That's
We're
right.
So glad that you're with us today. And it's a Christmas party, isn't it?
It's a party here
and
today.
And it's going to continue. Someone say Wednesday. Wednesday, we have a midweek Christmas service, and you want to be here. We're going to have a special message. We're going to have a kids' choir, so you know that's always fun to watch.
Yeah.
And we're going to even have a sunny oasis after the service in Lot 8. We're going to have
a snowy oasis.
Yeah, we're importing snow, and it's going to be great. And you want to be here for that. We got a movie under the stars, Fire Pits. We've got a paranda. Dios bendiga, see?
Yeah.
And I'm doing my best, y'all.
You're doing great.
And yeah, so bring your pots and pans. It's going to be great. We got dessert food trucks. It's going to be awesome. This Wednesday, our midweek Christmas service, you want to be here for that.
It's going to be amazing. We love celebrating Christmas as a church, and we believe this is a time where we can gather together, not just for community, but to honor and show our love to Jesus who was born. So on Christmas Day, we are actually having our special Christmas Day services. And this is going to be for the whole family. We're going to be in here together. It's going to be at 9 a.m. and 11:15. And we are inviting you to spend Christmas Day with us. It's going to be amazing. It's going to be incredible. There's going to be candles, carols, candy canes. It's going to be great. So join us next Sunday, right here, 9 a.m. and 11:15.
That's going to be awesome. So many great things. Hey, I want to let you know about something. Does anybody know what's happening January 1st? I just hear cheering. Yeah, so I hear a lot of excitement.
They
On January 1st, we're launching our 21 days of prayer and fasting. And we do this every single year. Last week, we filled out cards of things that we're going to be praying for and believing for. So you want to be a part of that. If you're new to Faith Assembly, we take the first part of every year when we pray and we fast. And if you want to know more about how to do some of that, you can go to faithassembly.org/21. How good is that? faithassembly.org/21, but put it in your calendar, put it in your heart. We're going to be starting 21 days of prayer and fasting January 1st.
We are so excited what God's doing here at Faith. And I just want to tell you one more thing to put in your calendar, and that's January 13th. We're actually having our Ministry Teams Conference. And this is for all those who serve, all our volunteers, all our leaders, Connect Grow, all that stuff, right? If you're involved in our church, this conference is for you. And it's going to be a time where we grow in our faith.
Yeah.
We're going to, you know, learn some leadership skills. It's going to be great. Pastor Johnnie's going to be sharing with us, but we're also going to be having Todd and Julie Mullins join us for this evening.
Wow.
It's going to be so good. And the best part of, right, is it's free. It's totally free. There's no cost. There's going to be a dinner provided, childcare. I'm not sure what kind of dinner, because it's like a fast, friendly dinner. So I don't know, but I'm sure it's going to be great, whatever it is. Okay, so we really want you to join us on January 13th for our Ministry Teams Conference.
Incredible. Excited
so
for that.
Good.
Well, are you glad you came today? It's going to be amazing. We're so glad that you're here. Enjoy the rest of the service. God bless you, and welcome to Christmas at Faith.
Faith Assembly, Michigan Street Campus, Red Bug Lake Campus, Curry Ford Campus. Are you excited? It's Christmas. Let me hear you say, oh yeah. Or if anybody maybe has a wishful dream for a white Christmas with some snow, let me hear you say, oh yeah. I said, is anybody out there hoping for a white Christmas this year? Let me hear you say, oh yeah. Say,
dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the treetops listen and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow.
Oh yeah!
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
Sing the dream with us. I'm dreaming.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the one I used to know, where the treetops listen and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. Christmas,
Gotta lose a couple more pounds before I wear this in church again. It's not working out too well for me. But Merry Christmas. Tell somebody near you Merry Christmas. This is the second time. Woo! Well, I want to take a moment to welcome our campuses one more. Let's give a big Merry Christmas to Red Bug Lake Campus. Michigan Street Campus, Merry Christmas to you as well. So I tell you what, dreaming of a white Christmas in sunny Orlando, Florida seems like a joke, right? It could be a bit of a pipe dream. Although we have heard that we've got like 28 degree weather next week. So is anybody holding out hope that maybe we see a flurry or two? That would be pretty cool. Not that Christmas traffic like up north though, but we'll take a little flurry or two. But when we're thinking about the dreams that we may have for Christmas, we all have varying dreams. Some dreams for different types of toys, different types of gifts, different experiences. My dream is for a yummy, yummy dinner, which is why I'm having a hard time with this wig. But though we have varying dreams, we all have the same hope. And that hope is in Christ Jesus. And hope is for love, for joy, for peace, and that our Savior would be able to illuminate the darkness in our lives. And so today, if we were to come up with a Christmas gift or a Christmas list collectively, we'd probably itemize those things for our world. That would be our grown-up Christmas list. God bless you.
Your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, your troubles will be miles away, away. Here we are as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends who are dear to us, gather near to us once more. Through the years we all will be together, if the fates allow. Hang a shining star upon the yourself a merry little Christmas now. Hang a shining star upon the highest bough, and have yourself a merry little Christmas now.
Wow, such talent in this church, young and old. Well, Merry Christmas, church. It's the giving season. How many of you love to give? And over at Michigan Street, why don't you respond? You love to give up at Red Bug Lake and out in the atrium and even online. Do you love to give? I know you do. If you know Christ and you have a personal relationship with Christ, you can't help but love to give. And it's the giving season, but the window is closing fast on this year. One of the reasons, I believe, that December is one of the highest months of giving in ministries and churches is because people get in the giving spirit and they realize all that Christ has done for them and their heart is stirred toward giving. Well, church, certainly God's tithe should always be given, amen? Should always. It's His. It belongs to Him. And even if we
spend it on something else, it's still God's tithe. So it belongs to Him. Let's don't drive it, wear it, or give it away to somebody else. Let's give God's tithe to Him. And then offerings. There's a great scripture. Matthew 2, verse 11 goes right along with the season. And when they had come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshiped. They fell down and what? Worshiped Him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented gifts to Him, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. That's where we get the idea. There were only three wise men because of the three gifts, but there could have been more bringing gold, more bringing frankincense. We don't know. But they brought gifts to Him. There's something about walking into the presence of God. You just want to give yourself. You want to give what you have because you realize and you're overwhelmed with the goodness of God. Well, I challenge you to evaluate. God, I'm going to do something special in this year end. Maybe you haven't been as faithful as you should. Maybe you can't make up for that right now, but you can do something in this year end, and then you can start next year to be more faithful in your giving and honoring God. Maybe gold, frankincense, and myrrh is not what you have, but we'll take the gold if you have that, all right? So, but maybe you've got stocks, and you don't want to pay the capital gains on that, so you can call the church office and transfer your stock and get credit for it. There's many ways to give. Even a few years back, I read where some of the companies in town will match any gift that you give toward nonprofits, which this church is. And people gave and let the business double it, and it was sent to the church. How neat is that? Double your tithes. Make your employer pay your tithes too. Well, whichever way you give, gold, frankincense, or myrrh, whatever you choose to give, you will be honored by it, and the windows of heaven will open over your life. There are many ways to give, as they'll show on the screen in a moment. Many ways to give. I love the church app. When I downloaded it and went on, it was so fun to give. And I don't know how it happened, but Amazon, it's right over my Faith Assembly app. They look alike. And so sometimes I hit Amazon and just buy something, all right? But I have to go back to Faith and give. There's a drop down that will give you options too of different things to give to. We're going to go to the Lord in prayer. Aren't you thankful for all He's done for you this year? And aren't you thankful for what He's going to do next year? Let's go to the Lord in prayer. God bless you, each and every one. Father, thank you so much. Over at Redbug, Lord, there may be someone that is going through a difficult time financially, or there at Michigan Street, or in the atrium here, online. There no doubt is. God, help them to see right now the power of giving, the power of sowing. And I pray out of that need, you would abundantly supply back to them. Meet every need in their lives, I pray. Bless your people as they give now. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you as you give.
Sophia, I'm the favorite sibling.
I am the favorite.
No,
I'm the favorite. I'm definitely the favorite. You're not the favorite. I'm the favorite.
I'm the favorite.
That's crazy, because I'm pretty sure I'm the favorite.
I think I'm the favorite. I think I would.
Which one do you think is the favorite, Sophia?
Thank you. heavenly peace, the scent of the century. From the makers of Don's Elite Life, products presented in this video are for entertainment purposes only. Moreover, viewers should not assume that any interaction with said products should serve as the receipt of or substitute for a personal relationship with the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Side effects of true heavenly peace may include love, joy, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Please check with the great physician, as heavenly peace can only come from our Heavenly Father. The cost of product in today's presentation is allegorical in nature, as you cannot put a price on salvation. Freedom is found only in Christ.
Yeah.
this time of year, or are you calling out to me? So I pray that I'm not too far gone for the Savior. This room at the end for a stranger. Is there mercy for someone? God, I pray to the King they say that came in a manger, who rescued me despite all my failures. Is there mercy for someone like me? Someone like me. Si me oyes, solo quiero escuchar tu voz. Que soy roto, que yo soy el hijo pródigo. Oh, pero te ruego hoy en mí haz un milagro, Dios. Oh, and I pray that I'm not too far gone for the Savior, and that there's a room at the end for a stranger.
In 1994, two Americans accepted the invitation from the Russian education department to come and teach morals and ethics to students in the public schools. And as they go and begin to teach that, they were doing it with biblical principles to teach morals and ethics. Not only in the public schools, they end up getting invited also to teach in prisons, got to teach in police departments and fire departments. And also they got to teach these morals and ethics in a very large orphanage. And it came to this time of year. And as part of those teachings in that large orphanage, these two Americans decided to teach these children, many most for the first time, about the story of Christmas. The story of Jesus coming to this earth. They read for them the book of Luke chapter 2. Verses like verses 4 through 7 that say, Joseph went up to Galilee from the town of Nazareth to Judea to the city of David, which was called Bethlehem, because he was from the house and the lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed. That verse goes on to say that as they arrived there in Bethlehem, Mary begins to, it becomes the time for Mary to have the child. And so as she is now ready to have the child, they're looking for somewhere for this child to be birthed. And those verses tell us that there is no room for her in the inn. So these teachers tell this story to these children, and they retell it later that these kids were on the very edge of their seat. I mean, they were listening to every single word. And as part of that project, they began to hand out some different crafts, and they handed each child three small pieces of cardboard with which they were going to build the manger that Jesus was laid in. They were handed a little yellow napkin where the kids could cut the napkin into strips, and that would represent the hay. They handed the kids a little piece of flannel from an old nightgown, and that was going to be the baby's blanket. And then they handed the kids a tan piece of felt that could be cut in the shape, and that would represent the baby Jesus on their project. So they began to go and look at each kid's progress of this little set that they were building, and everything is fine until they get to one little six-year-old boy named Misha. And his looked different than everybody else's, and they got to Misha's, and instead of one piece of tan felt in there to represent the baby Jesus, there were two babies inside of his manger. So the Americans called the translators over just to make sure that he heard the story right and understood the assignment. And they began to ask him questions. They said, "Can you recite to us the story that you heard?" And I mean, with exact detail, he began to explain Joseph and Mary arriving and not having anywhere for the baby to be born, and no room in the inn. And they had to place Jesus in this manger. And he gets to that point of the story of Mary placing Jesus in the manger, and he begins to improvise the story. And he says, "As Mary was placing Jesus in the manger, Jesus looked at me," little Misha said. "Jesus looked at me and asked if I had anywhere to stay. And I told him, 'No, I don't, because I have no mama and I have no papa.' And Jesus said that I could stay with him for always." That's me in the manger. These teachers were blown away at this little Russian six-year-old boy named Misha, who understood the meaning and the power of Christmas, maybe more than some of us even do today. Here's what I mean by that. A lot gets said of those verses in Luke chapter 2, that there was no room for Jesus in the inn, and that God had come to man and man didn't have room for him. And so that question gets posed to us maybe around this time of year: have you made room for Jesus? And it's a worthy question to ask yourself. But that's not the most meaningful, the most impactful part of Christmas, is whether or not man has made room for Jesus. The most meaningful, impactful moment of the Christmas season is that God has made room for you. When you didn't deserve it, when none of us do, that by God sending Jesus into this world to be our Savior, he has provided for us the opportunity to have reconciliation with him for always. That we could spend eternity with Jesus. That's the message of Christmas. Not does man receive him, but the fact and the miracle that God would receive us. There's another verse in the book of Galatians chapter 4 that talks about Christmas. It's not a verse that you think of when, or you don't usually go to the book of Galatians when you're looking for Christmas verses, but it talks about the power of Christmas when it says, when the time had fully come, God sent his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those under the law, that we might receive adoption. Now here's what I know. I know whether it's here in this building or at one of our campuses, or maybe you're watching somewhere else, maybe you're all by yourself, just in front of a screen. Listen, God ordained this moment. And I know this, that there are some of us, and we are in need of that adoption. Like this Christmas season, yeah, we need to consider both of those questions. We need to consider the question, have I made room for Jesus? But we also need to consider the claim that Christ has made room for you. And that God extends his love to you. And some of us would go, yeah, but I don't deserve it. I haven't done anything to merit this kind of sacrifice, that God would come in human form and live a
perfect life and die in my place. I don't deserve that. And I know that's the amazing part of the love of God, that even though we don't deserve it, he's come to save you. I'm going to give you an opportunity today to realize the power of salvation, to realize what it means. Everybody talks about hope at this time of year and peace on earth, this peace in our souls. The world could be falling apart around us, but you could have peace today. And Christmas, just a lot of times it's a season of laughter and fun and parties and gifts, and everybody's smile, got a smile on their face, and maybe that does not represent 2022's Christmas for you. And listen, even if your world's falling apart, you can still have peace and know that there is a purpose to your life and that you have been reconciled with God. And I believe that all of us sense somewhere in our heart, maybe you haven't believed this stuff before and you go, well, I don't know if this is true. You may say that it's not true, but you cannot say that it's trivial. Christmas has impacted this story of a Savior born to the earth. It has impacted the world. And we're still talking about it today. Would you do me a favor across all of our campuses? Would you bow your heads and close your eyes? Nobody looking around. This is really between you and God. That's why I ask you to close your eyes, just so you can kind of look in. And there are many of us who are right now outside of this relationship with Jesus Christ. We've not been adopted in. We've gone our own way. Maybe there's a point in your life when you thought about what God could mean to you. But maybe life caught up with you. Maybe you started doing your own thing, going your own direction, your own desires, and that sin separated you from God. Or maybe you have never before accepted this invitation to know God personally. And I want to give you a chance to do that today. It's a decision that you make. It's a turnaround of your life. It's not a certain formula of words you put together and get access to heaven. No, this is a decision you make in your heart to believe on who Jesus is and to believe that his life and death provides life for you today. Spiritual life, eternal life, that you would be with him for always. So nobody's looking around, but if that's you today, you know who you are. I don't need a list of all your wrongdoings or of all the things that's caused you to feel separated and feel a million miles away from God. I don't need that today, but I'm going to ask you right now, if you feel like you need forgiveness of your sin, if you feel like you need to be established in a relationship with God or reestablish your relationship with God, if that's you today, I want to pray for you quickly and pray with you. But if that's you, let's do this. In just a moment, I'm going to ask you to raise your hand saying, I need Christ today. I need this Christmas season to be the season in which I got right with God. If that's you, when I say three, I want you to raise your hand. Are you ready? All across this building, there at our campuses, there in the atrium, I need Christ today. If that's you, one, two, it's the best decision you could ever make. Three, if that's you, let me see your hand. I need Christ. Yes, yes, yes. Come on, hold it up for just a second. Thank you. In the risers, hold it up for just a second. Thank you. Thank you. Yes, yes. I believe there is a genuineness to these hands going up in the air. Anybody else, you need to be a part of this prayer. Pastor, include me. I need Christ today. Thank you. That's why we're here. That's why you're here. Listen, you may have thought, well, I came just to hear some Christmas music. No, you came into this moment. You're a part of this service right now because God ordained to reach out to you in this Christmas season and say, you can be with me. You can be with me. Why don't we do this? I'm going to ask everybody across all of our campuses to pray with me. And as we pray this prayer, it's just to articulate, to help us all articulate the decision we've made in our heart, the belief that we have placed our minds on right now. And so let's pray this together. Come on, out loud, across. Let's just all join. Those that lifted their hand and those of us who are already living for the Lord, come on, let's just say this prayer out loud together. Say, Jesus, I thank you for inviting me. I don't deserve it, but thank you for loving me. Thank you for living for me. Thank you for dying for me. And Lord, I thank you that you're alive inside of me today. I give you my heart. I give you my life. Forgive me. Cleanse me. Oh, and I like this prayer to say, Lord, make me new. In Jesus' name,
Amen. Amen. Now here, I want you to do something. Praise God. I want you to do something, especially if you've never prayed that prayer before, but even if you're coming back to Jesus, I want to encourage you to do something. Grab your phone, and you'll need it in just a second anyway, but take your phone and type the word save. That's what happened to you just now. Your soul has been saved. You're born again. Type the word save to the number there on the screen, and it just marks what a special today, what a special day today is. And so I know you've enjoyed this. I want to say thank you to all the team that has put this incredible production together. And let's give God praise for an incredible holiday season. We love you. God bless you.
It's Christmas,
and
already one of those days. Need me a pick-me-up or something. Oh, what's this? Heavenly peace. I can definitely use some of that.
I'll take a medium heavenly peace. Make it a large.
I wonder if she knows.
Oh, she knows. But she doesn't care. Heavenly peace. The flavor of favor.
From the makers of Don's Elite, products presented in this video are for entertainment purposes only. Moreover, viewers should not assume that any interaction with said products should serve as the receipt of or substitute for a personal relationship with the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Side effects of true heavenly peace may include love, joy, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Please check with the great physician, as heavenly peace can only come from our Heavenly Father. The cost of product in today's presentation is allegorical in nature, as you cannot put a price on salvation. Freedom is found only in Christ.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas, Faith Assembly. Come on, won't you stand up to your feet and let's clap our hands and let's wish each other the best Christmas and Happy New Year that we could ever have together. Come on, here we go.
Wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. Wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Say it a bunch of times today, but can you turn to somebody near you and tell them Merry Christmas? Merry Christmas. We are so thankful that you were here with us today. Red Bug Lake Campus, Michigan Street Campus, God bless you. We're thankful that you were here with us today as well. Didn't our Faith Worship Arts team do a phenomenal job today? Let's give a big thank you, Jesus, for our team today. We also thank our media team who put this thing together. We thank Faith Integrity Dance. We thank Pastor Sonia and the Main Street. And our youth do a phenomenal job today. Oh, yes. And we're just so thankful that we were able to celebrate this with you. Take Christ with you every day, and let's have a wonderful rest of this season. God bless you, and may his peace be with you till we meet again. You take care.